Hello students. So students, in the previous class, in this chapter, that is matter around us pure, we were talking about the different kind of a separation technique. So we were discussing that what are the different separating technique that we used for separating the mixtures of the solid to that of the liquid. So how can we separate the solid from that of the liquid? So the first thing that we have seen here, students, and that is by using a process, and that is called filtration. What happened in case of the filtration? So here we have taken a filter paper, and this filter paper is kept on an iron rod, and there just below to that of the filter paper, which is kept on the funnel, just below to that of the funnel, we have taken a beaker. And when you pour the solution, the mixture of the solid and that of the liquid from each other with the help of the filter paper, you will find that the insoluble solid, it will be filtered with the help of the filter paper in the form of residue. It means that will not going to pass through that of the filter paper, but it will remain as a residue on the filter paper. While that of the filtrate, which is the liquid one, will get separated in the form of filtrate in the another beaker. So the solid will get separated with the help of the process, that is filtration, when the solid is insoluble in that of the liquid. So when the solid which is dissolved in the liquid is insoluble, we are able to separate them with the help of the filter paper, with the help of the process, and that is known as filtration. Then the second thing we have understood, student, and that is centrifugation. What is a centrifugation now? So in case of a centrifugation, we have used a machine that is known as centrifugate. So in that of the centrifugate, we will add the solid and the liquid together, that of the solution together, and keep it into that of the centrifuge machine. Okay, that is the centrifugate, and rotate it. So when the centrifugate machine rotated, what will happen? This makes that of the solid component to combine together and become heavy and finally settle down. So the role of the centrifugation machine is make the suspended solid particles to combine together and become heavy and settle down. We have seen that in case of the washing machine also, you see, student, blood components are there, the components which is present in the urine, all these things are separated with the help of a centrifugate process of centrifugation. Milk is also there, so skimmed milk is separated through that of the centrifugation. So we have seen up to centrifugation and that of the filtration. Now let us move and try to understand the next separation method, and that is evaporation. So you see, students, that what happened in case of the evaporation. So here, in case of the evaporation, we are able. Okay, so in case of the evaporation, student, what we will here find here, that the when you take a solid and that of the liquid components, and when you heat it, what will happen? The liquid, one of the liquid will get evaporated and the solid will remain as such. Okay, so you see that if suppose you have mixed something in that of the water, and when you provide heat to it, then what will happen? The water will evaporate. Normally the process of the evaporation we will going to use when we have made the solution with the help of a solvent, and that is water. Only then when you supply a sufficient amount of heat, the water will get converted into water vapor and get separated from that of the solid. Okay, so we can see that if suppose we have used a solid mixed with the liquid, if it is water, we can separate it again with the help of the evaporation process. Let us try to understand that.
the use of this process, the use of the process,
the use of the process of evaporation, the use of the process of evaporation for separating a mixture, for separating a mixture is based on a fact, is based on the fact that liquid vaporizes
but solid
do not
vaporize.
Okay, so liquid vaporizes but the solid it do not vaporize easily. Okay, now you see here students, I'll explain you about that. So when you have taken the water mixed in any of the solid or a solid is mixed into a water, what will happen? When you heat it, this water will get vaporized. It means it gets converted into water vapor. But the solid remain as such. So here we are going, this method or this separating technique we are going to use when the liquid can easily get converted into vapor but the solid do not get converted into vapor, only then we are going to prefer the process of the evaporation. Now let us see some of the examples. On the basis of that we are able to understand that when and where we are going to use the evaporation process. So the first one we can see here, and that is separation of common salt and water. You see students, a very easy one. Now you see, okay, so you have taken a container and in which you have taken water. Now add a few amount of salt in it. Suppose you have taken a glass and which is filled with the water, and now you have added 2 to 3 tablespoons of salt in it and dissolve it. What will happen? You will find that the salt can easily dissolve with the water. So here a solid is the salt which is dissolved in a liquid, that is water. So this is a mixture which consisting of a solid and a liquid. Now what we have to understood here, that how we are able to separate them. So we are able to separate them in which we are knowing that if suppose you will going to heat salt, the salt will not going to vaporize, but when you heat the water, water will vaporize. So now you have taken the mixture of the salt which is dissolved in the water. Now you have, when you heat this water which is already consisting of a salt in it, you will find that water keeps on evaporating. And finally, when all the water will get evaporated, you will see that the container in which you are providing the heat, you will see that there the bottom of the container is totally filled with, or you can say that the surface is covered with that of the salt. So you can find the salt to the bottom of the container which you are heating. So water get evaporated but the salt remain as such. So you can see that here we are able to separate the water from the salt. So is this relatable to any method that we can use in a common commonly is used? Yes, this method of separating the salt and the water from each other is also used for obtaining salt from the sea water. So this process of the separation occur on a large scale. So basically what happened there, the people, they used to collect, they used to make small pits, and they used to collect the seawater there. Now these pits are exposed to that of the sunlight, and when the sufficient amount of sunlight falls on the different pits, which is consisting of seawater in it, water keeps on evaporating. Now water keeps on evaporating and salt will remain as such. Then the salt can be extracted easily. So you can say that the process of the evaporation occur on a large scale. Occurs on a large scale. Okay, so extraction of salt from seawater is carried out through the process of evaporation. Okay, through the process of evaporation. So we can say here that with the help of the evaporation process, we are able to separate the common salt from that of the water. Sorry, student, it will be a common salt and water. So separation of the common salt and water can be separated by using the evaporation method. Is there any other example, student, by which we are able to separate them? Yes. If ink is mixed into the water, there also we are able to separate the ink from that of the water. But remember, we will not going to provide the heat directly to that of the ink. You know that ink is basically made up of a solid dyes are mixed into the water, and that is why there is a formation of a ink. So if suppose you want to separate the blue dye from the blue ink, you will use this evaporation process to separate it. But here, while separating it, we should remember that we are not going to give a direct heat to that of the blue ink or the ink, otherwise it will be charred. So we will give a water bath to this ink, and due to which the water get evaporated from the ink and dye will remain as such. Let us write about it that. So, separation of the blue ink in a mixture. The blue ink is a mixture of a dye, is a mixture of a dye in water. Blue ink is a mixture of a dye in water. Okay, so dye is what, student? Dye is a colored component. Okay, it is what? It is a colored component of the ink. Okay, it is the colored component of the ink, and we can separate it through the process of evaporation. Okay, so we can say, basically what happened here, student, we will take a bowl, you can say, and there When you will take that bowl and you will keep the ink solution in a petri dish or any of the watch glass, and instead of giving direct heat to it, when you will give heat to the water start boiling, and when the water start boiling, you will keep that of the petri dish over that of the boiling water. What will happen due to the heat of it? What will happen? That heat will make the water which is present in the dye to evaporate, and the colored component, the solid component of the dye, will remain as such. So by the process of the evaporation, we are able to separate the mixture of a blue ink dye in water also. Okay, so we are able to separate the water from the dye with the help of the evaporation. So this is the next one, student. Now, evaporation is not only the separating technique that we use for separating the solid to the liquid, but we have also seen the crystallization was also there. So crystallization process is the next, which is used for separating the solid to the liquid components, or mixture of a solid and liquid to each other. Crystallization. Crystallization, student. So by the name itself, it is understood. Crystallization, it means to get crystals. So here the solution is first heated. When it become very heat, when it become very hot, then it is cooled. So first of all, it is heated and then it is cooled, and due to which we will obtain crystals. So this is what this happens in the process of the crystallization. So we can say that the process of cooling a hot concentrated solution, hot concentrated solution of a substance, concentrated solution of a substance, to obtain a crystal. So first of all, we will heat the solution, the concentrated solution, and after heating it, we will left it for cooling. So when we cool this hot concentrated solution, we will obtain the crystals from it. And to obtain the crystals is the process of crystallization. Okay, so it is a process by which we obtain the crystals of a substance, and that is crystallization. And how do we get it? We get it by cooling a hot and a concentrated solution. Okay, basically what happened here, student, the crystals that we obtain, it is actually the pure solid substance. So by this, we are able to separate. Concentrated solution means what? Which consisting of the liquid in it. So when you continuously heating, what will happen? It will makes the solution concentrated, and when you cool it, we are able to get the solid component, which is a pure form of the solid. Okay, so it is used to obtain. It is used to obtain a pure solid substance. Pure solid substance from impure sample. So our impure sample is given to you, and to obtain the pure solid substance from this impure sample is called as the crystallization. So let us try to understand that what is the procedure of the crystallization, means how do we obtain crystals from this process of crystallization, and how can we say that this is the pure form of the solid component. So the first thing that is, we will take a impure solid substance and dissolve in a liquid or dissolve in a water. Then we are going to filter it. While filtering, what will happen, the things which is impure and which the impurities which remain suspended, it will get filtered out. Now the solid component which remain dissolved in the water is heated. It is heated on the water bath until and unless it becomes a hot concentrated solution. When it becomes a hot concentrated solution, then we will keep it so that it will get cooled down. While cooling, you will find that the solid component will form a crystal-like a substance. So it will become crystal. Now, we can separate the crystal from that of the liquid. It means the impurities will remain in the liquid, while the solid that in the form of a crystal is a pure form of a solid will be obtained, and it can be obtained by filtering it again and then drying it. We will get the pure solid. So by this method, we are able to separate the solid component from that of the liquid component, or the impure solid to the pure solid component. Let us write the procedure again, students. So you see, what is the procedure of the crystallization? It is an important one, because the other you are knowing, most of them is, especially if we talk about the evaporation process, but crystallization is a new term for you people. So the first thing is, procedure. First is impure solid substance is mixed or is dissolved in the minimum amount of water. So first of all, an impure solid substance is taken and it is dissolved in a minimum amount of water. The second one, now this solution is filtered to remove any insoluble impurities is there. So we have made it to dissolve in the water, but now we will going to filter it, that maybe that there are some impurities which is not dissolved in it. So we have to remove it by using the process of a filtration. So we can write it now. The solution is filtered. Solution is filtered to remove any insoluble impurities. Insoluble impurities. Okay. So we can say that at first we will take this and filter it to remove any insoluble impurities. Now this clear solution is heated gently with the help of the water bath until and unless we will make it as a concentrated or a saturated solution. So the clear solution is heated gently on a water bath till a concentrated solution or a saturated solution is obtained. So we are now continuously heating it until and unless we will get a saturated solution or we will going to get a concentrated solution of this clear solution. Now we get the saturated solution, student. Now what we will going to do? We will allow the hot substance to cool down. Okay. So next one is allow the hot solution. Allow the hot solution. Hot solution, or we can write hot saturated solution. To cool down slowly. Okay, to cool slowly. Okay, we will allow this hot saturated solution to cool slowly. What happened next? You will find that the crystal of a pure solid substance can be seen easily. Okay, so next one is that crystal of pure solid are formed. So this crystal of pure solid is formed. What about the impurities? It will remain present in the liquid one, okay, or in the solution. Impurities will remain in solution. Okay, so crystal of the pure solids are formed while the impurities are there, it will remain in the solution. Then the next one is, okay, we get now the pure solid. Now it is the time to separate it. So we will separate out that of the pure solid from the solution. So separate the pure crystals crystals of solid from the solution. Okay, so we can say that we are able to separate. Now we are going to separate this pure crystal of the solid from the solution. So this basically you can say that from that of the impure crystal, from that of the impure solid, we have obtained a pure crystal of the solid here, students. Okay, so first of all we have taken that of the solid, that impure solid, and we will add into the water, where the minimum amount of our water, we will add in the minimum amount of our water. So if the amount of the water is less, obviously it will going to make a saturated solution. So by adding it, what will happen? The solid will get dissolved in it. Now there is chance that the solid, there are some of the solid components are there which remain insoluble. So if it will remain insoluble, it will going to float on the surface of the liquid, on the solution. Now what we will going to do, we will separate it with the help of the filter paper or by the process of the filtration. When you filter it by the process of a filtration, then then the impurities will remain on the filter paper as a residue, while that of the dissolved or the soluble solid will comes out with the solution. Now solution is ready. This is the clear solution. Then this clear solution is now kept it on a water bath, and on the water bath it will be heated gently. Okay, so when you heat it gently, what will happen? Continuously the water get evolved from it and it will become more saturated or more concentrated. Okay, and until and unless it becomes a concentrated, we have to keep on heating this solution. Okay, when it become concentrated, when it become a when it become the saturated, then we will leave it, and finally we will keep it so that it will cool down slowly. And this hot and concentrated solution, when it cools down, you will find that there is a formation of a crystal occur, and then this while impurities, other impurities will remain in the solution. Now this crystal is a pure solid form of a crystal, and we will separate them through the solution easily. Okay, so example is here, student, impure copper sulfate. So copper sulfate can be purified through the process of the crystallization.